Welcome to evening prayers for today, Monday, the 4th of April, the last of my 7 days with you. We've been exploring themes in the middle section of the prophecy of Isaiah. Thank you for sharing this journey with me. There's a message of comfort to the exiles beginning to contemplate a return to their own country and to Jerusalem. And as we're still finding, there were issues. And we're following the themes for these days of the month in the Methodist Prayer Handbook, praying with churches in different parts of the world and for the districts of the British Methodist Church. Today we are challenged by our Great Commission. Our opening prayers this week have been based on material from the Iona Community. Let's be still. In the mystery of your presence, no words are needed. In the depth of your silence, no sound is necessary. In the face of your word, no voice need respond. Be still, you say, and know that I am God. So we will be still and listen. We will be still, for we are on holy ground. We will be still, because you call us. And so we will wait, patiently or impatiently, we will wait for our commission. The word of God from Isaiah chapter 49. And verses 1 to 6. Listen to me, you islands, hear this, you distant nations. Before I was born, the Lord called me. From my mother's womb, he has spoken my name. He made my mouth like a sharpened sword. In the shadow of his hand, he hid me. He made me into a polished arrow and concealed me in his quiver. He said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, in whom I will display my splendor." But I said, "I have labored in vain. I have spent my strength for nothing at all. Yet what is due to me is in the Lord's hand, and my reward is with my God." And now the Lord says, "He who formed me in the womb to be his servant, to bring Jacob back to him and gather Israel to himself. For I am honored in the eyes of the Lord, and my God has been my strength." He says, "It is too small a thing for you to be my servant to restore the tribes of Jacob and bring back those of Israel I have kept. I will also make you a light for the Gentiles, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth." Our journey with Isaiah is not complete, but this is the last of these 7 days. We began last Tuesday being reminded of the inspiration and strength that God offers, not just to soar like an eagle, but to run and not be weary, to walk and not faint. And today we end with a promise from God. Words now are put into the mouth of the servant, though variously the verses make it sound as if the servant is the whole nation Israel, or someone embodying the nation, perhaps the emerging leader who will lead them back to their homeland. And in our Christian understanding, of course, God's perfect servant was made human in Christ. God gives a vote of confidence. But the response is less than triumphal. "Listen, I have labored in vain, I have achieved nothing." But there is still confidence. The language is the language of a court of law. What is due to me is in the Lord's hand. So in renewed confidence, the servant reports God's final call, not just to restore the exiles to nationhood, but in the words of Simeon in the temple, to be a light for the Gentiles, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth. Our calling then is in global terms. No wonder we need to be able to walk as well as soaring and running. Our hymn reflects the stages by which we respond to call, as the servant did in Isaiah's poem. This Iona hymn offers to God our past, our tiredness, our fears. We respond not in spite of these, not setting ourselves aside, but secure, because God knows us as we are. What is due to me is in the Lord's hand. As we conclude these 7 days with Isaiah, God's call is to fullness of life and to the fulfillment of who we are. I don't know how you normally share these songs in our time together, but this evening you may like to sit quietly and absorb the words on the screen as the singers bring them to us. Take this moment, sign and space, in Singing the Faith, number 530.
Thank you.
And so to our prayers. Again, a couple of Celtic prayers from David Adam. Let's pray. Christ be in your heart. Glory fills your days, for he is the King of glory. If Christ be in your mind, peace is in all your ways, for he is the Prince of peace. If Christ be in your deeds, joy your life will raise, for he is the giver of joy. If Christ be in your will, strength of purpose stays, for he is the centre of strength. Lord, today has brought paths to discover, possibilities to choose, people to encounter, peace to possess, promises to fulfill, perplexities to ponder, power to strengthen, pointers to guide, pardon to release, praises to sing, and a presence to proclaim. As the day ends, we wrap that presence around us. On this fourth day of the month, we pray with Christians in Equatorial Guinea and in Ghana. We pray for the leaders of the church in Equatorial Guinea. May they continue raising disciples, sharing the word of life, and demonstrating the love of God in the power of the Holy Spirit. May our partnership with the church strengthen our faith, beautify our worship, and boost our devotion to God. And we pray for the President of Ghana and all those in national and local government. May they be blessed with wisdom and integrity so that they can account for themselves on the day of judgment. We pray for all the people of Ghana. Lord, may they hear your voice, love mercy, and walk humbly with you. In our own connection, we pray with the Bedfordshire, Essex and Hertfordshire district, and with David Chapman, the district chair. God of grace and mercy, with joy we profess and proclaim that you have reconciled us to yourself through the life, death and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. In your great love for this world and all its people, you have called your church to share in Christ's ministry of reconciliation. We give thanks for the rich diversity found among the people of God in every time and place. Open our eyes and hearts to recognize where injustice, discrimination, and thoughtlessness continue to exclude some people from fully belonging to your family, the Church. Amid worldly divisions that oppress, strengthen us to live boldly as servants of your reconciling purposes in this world, so that all may belong and flourish. Amen. And with Pope Francis, we share a prayer for peace. Lord God of peace, hear our prayer. We have tried so many times and over so many years to resolve our conflicts by our own powers and by the force of arms. How many moments of hostility and darkness have we experienced? How much blood has been shed? How many lives have been shattered? How many hopes have been buried? But our human efforts have been in vain. Lord, forgive us. Lord, now come to our aid. Grant us peace, teach us peace, guide our steps in the way of peace. Open our eyes and our hearts, and give us the courage to take real steps to achieve peace. Lord God of Abraham, God of the prophets, God of love, give us the strength daily to be instruments of peace. Enable us to see everyone who crosses our path as our sister, our brother. May nations be willing to turn weapons of war into implements of peace, our trepidation into confident trust, our quarreling into forgiveness. Lord, keep alive within us the flame of hope, so that with patience and perseverance we may encourage dialogue and reconciliation. Defuse the violence of our tongues and our hands. May the words division, hatred, and war be banished from the heart of every man and woman. Renew our hearts and minds, so that our way of life will always be that of our Saviour Jesus Christ, the Lord of peace. Amen. And we share the Lord's Prayer using our more modern version or any form or language which is appropriate for you. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. And to close our 7 days, a less familiar prayer of St. Ignatius. O Christ Jesus, when all is darkness and we feel our weakness and helplessness, give us the sense of your presence, your love, and your strength. Help us to have perfect trust in your protecting love and strengthening power, so that nothing may frighten or worry us. For living close to you, we shall see your hand, your purpose, your will, through all things. Amen. Thank you for sharing this time together and all the times together this week. Tomorrow, our student minister, Laura Martin, takes over. Wherever you are, whatever your faith, may the blessing of God beyond us, God alongside us, and God within us be with us this night and always. Amen. Oh,